Hello, welcome back to another Values and Show. I'm Jacob J at Books Corner. Today we are talking about my top 5 worst books of 2023. I will also like to mention that today is December 20th. My worst list, there could be a new book that I read before the end of the year that's like, oh my god, that's wretched. Necessarily think I have any books like slated that could be a top 5 worst. I have a few books that could be very disappointing that could classify under a disappointing. Let's go ahead and get started. I'm also going to mention my most disappointing book in this video as well, because I don't have a list for most disappointing. I wouldn't be surprised if this is not labeled worst books. I don't know. I normally don't label it because I feel like that's really strong, but I would like to mention all these books are either 2 or 1 star. All my top books or whatever are either 2 or 1 star. My most disappointing book, I also try to pick from like a 2 star. I think most disappointing could also fall under 3 star if you're looking for like superlatives and stuff. With that being said, let's go ahead and talk about it. I didn't have a lot of 1 stars and 2 stars this year. I think overall I had 4, like summarized the 1.5 to 1.75 category, and I grabbed a 2 star that I felt like really was important to talk about. My most disappointing read, I just did a video on it. I'll link it in the cards. It was a 5 star prediction video. And that is A Twisted Love Story by Samantha Downing. I have already said it. I will not put Samantha Downing, at least not next year, in a 2024 to read in 2024 or 24 books to read in 2024 video. She also will not be, unless she has like another 5 star popping up, she won't be in a 5 star prediction for any years to come. I will continue to pick up Samantha Downing without a doubt. This one book is not going to turn me. I will have to say on retrospect thinking, I think it's a 1.5 star. That sucks. That sucks. It was a 2 in that video, but I just really hate the book. And the more I think about the book, I really hate it more and more. There's just no point to it. I can't find a reason to recommend it or anything like that. I couldn't really tell you who would like this. Maybe Colleen Hoover fans could like it, because like it's kind of trash. Like Colleen Hoover books are kind of trash. Surprisingly, November 9 is not on this list. That is shocking to me. I almost think that's a crime. That being said, let's go ahead and jump into the top five worst books of 2024. I didn't really go out searching for 10. I'm sure I probably have more than this. I'm like, Colleen Hoover's not on here. I read that for a video as well, in case you guys are curious. My opinions on that in that video are relatively short for that particular book. With that being said, let's go ahead and get started. Number 5, I read for a video that got canceled, which was a reread favorite video where I sit down and I talk to you about my thoughts and opinions after I finished reading a reread favorite. I do think the ending of reading this, or the beginning part, was in a 24-hour readathon, so if I can find that video, I'll link it for you. But that book would be Impulse by Alan Hopkins. I read this back in 2013, 2014, when I was in, I want to say probably middle school, and it was everything. It was beautiful. I liked the fact it ended on 666 pages. I love the last line, or if I would say I loved the last line at some point, not anymore, really, of the book, which was like, it's like all about a perfect paper airplane, which really felt like summarized the story up a lot. I really liked the characterization of several characters originally, and then on reread it was trash. It was one of the worst things I've read this year for sure. I think it's even worse because I think it's still being promoted to kids today, and this is like one of the most homophobic books I've ever read in my life. The idea that who is going through a metamorphosis of trying to figure out his sexuality, and there's several characters in here who are hating him because he is gay, and so he ends up in this love triangle with a woman, and I just think it's horribly done. It's truly horribly done. I'm not gonna lie to you, a little TMI information, it's definitely the book I needed when I was like 14 or 15 to tell me, oh, I can just go fall in love with a woman too if I'm not gay. Because I am gay. I'm going to get married to a man. So I just think it's promoting the wrong message, and I don't think it's done really well. I ended up posting that video because I could not really articulate my thoughts in a perfect way. Never saw the light of day, and I have no plans on rereading it to gather the notes again. I will not be taking, please do the video, roast the shit. It's roasted. Okay? It was horrible. It was truly horrible. The next one, I guess, could be like an honorable, dishonorable mention, just because like I've set my grievances with this novel. My number 4 choice is also from a video that I have canceled in the past. I just didn't end up liking it. I can't remember why I never posted the Hunger Games video. But this past year, I reread the Hunger Games, the entire like trilogy, and also the Ballad of Songbirds and Snakes. Part of the reason why I wanted to read the Ballad of Songbirds and Snakes, obviously the movie came out. The movie's phenomenal. Could not recommend it enough. It's available to right now. Go rent it. But the book is trash. The book is like one of the worst worst things. It set me into a reading slump. This is a novel that did it, guys. I can pinpoint it. I can pinpoint probably the page. I don't want to find it because it's just horrible. It's horrible. I couldn't tell you why it's bad, why I hated it so much. I don't know if it's because it reads so differently from The Hunger Games. And then I read The Hunger Games like right afterwards and I was like, oh, that's good. And I read Catching Fire and I was like, that's better. And then I read Mockingjay and I said, that's still trash. So like, you know, this was bad. This was bad, Suzanne. You probably should not come back and revisit the series again. Unless you want to make more movies. I'm okay with making more movies. The movie was good. Next is a video that I can't decide if I'm on, if I'm canceling or not overall. I had a video, I made a video where I basically went through my entire unread TBR pile on my bookshelves. There's quite a few books on my bookshelves I've never read before. I've had quite a few more books added, and I made a TBR, and in that TBR I said if Where the Crawdads Sing by Delilah Owens ever gets a movie, then I would love to read the book and then watch the movie and tell you guys my thoughts and opinions on both, and I will read the book for this video. The audiobook came in, which is the reason why this is the only book I read. I have a few, like five other books up there for this one video, all that I think could possibly be really good, that I could really enjoy. Objectively, there's nothing wrong with those books or anything. This was just so bad that it kind of just pushed me off from that video. I will still probably keep it, and maybe one day we'll come back and read those like six other books. Who knows? Where the Crawdads Sing follows a murder mystery about a woman who was convicted of murdering the person that she was supposedly in love with, and it's about her fighting that case and things. There's a lot of reasons why this book is bad. I have a rant TikTok talking about it on the internet somewhere. Well, on my TikTok. Link down below. There's so many different reasons. One of my biggest takeaways outside of the blatant racism, which is throughout the entire thing, and I saw some reviews being like, it's a part of the time. Oh, shut up. I don't care. The author is racist. Like objectively, the author is racist. And she is a racist woman. So, like, if she is a racist woman and she writes racist media, I'm just going to assume it's because she's racist. I would say my biggest takeaway, the problem I have most with this book outside of, like, yeah, I saw that coming or whatever, the basic stuff you can say about a mystery thriller right now, is the sexualization of a child was just so gratuitous, in my opinion, in this novel, that it was disgusting. Also, some grooming relationships and other stuff made me really uncomfortable. From my understanding, the movie took away all those aspects, and I heard the movie's pretty good, and I heard it's a pretty good adaptation, so if that is of interest to you, I don't know if I will watch it. I have not. I read that back in, like, March. Number two would have to be Batman Nightwalker by Marie Lu. Speaking of a graphic novel that I truly thought was god awful, this would be it. This is by far the worst graphic novel I read all year. What even was it? I know it's part of like the DC Icons, and I've been told to read the DC Icons instead of reading them in a graphic novel format, and maybe next year I'll make a whole video talking about all the DC Icon video books, because I'm sure I'll fall for it again, okay? I'm just not really ready. Other than the fact that the horrible blue and the god-awful yellow being a part of this entire thing, the story was absolutely horrible. It doesn't even follow Batman. I think that's my biggest takeaway. It is definitely like a Bruce Wayne story, or kind of like a Bruce Wayne story. I think the marketing here was pretty bad, and I just feel like overall, I had no fun. I had no fun. I really didn't like it, and I don't think it added anything to Batman at all. Was not worth it. And lastly, the last one I have is a translated novel, which is called The Law of Skies, which I'll put up on the screen. I don't know who wrote it. I don't even think I can pronounce who wrote it, to be honest with you. I think this is based on the original translation was German, I want to say, and it was translated over into English. This is about a group of boys, probably like kindergarten to first grade, who are going off onto a field trip, and horrible, horrible things start to happen to them. I was told, like, Winnie the Pooh, not joking. It's like The Troop or something out of those lines. And it was one of the worst things that I had endured. It didn't make any sense whatsoever. Once again, I don't know if it's just like the translation copy. I'm going to assume it's because of the translation copy. It was just like one of the hardest things I had this year to read. There's this whole B-plot storyline about this story within a story within a story that's super duper confusing. And I would also say a lot of things that the characters do, especially the younger kids do, are so despicable and vile in this book that I didn't believe it, which also took away the scary element of being like when kids do horrible things, I want to actually think a kid could do that. And that's what makes it terrifying. This was not the case. I would not recommend The Law of Skies. And I know I feel like I should have much more, like, a harsher opinion. It's just been so long since I read it. I think I read it back in, like, January or February of this last year, or, you know, this year. And so it's been so many months that, like, my thoughts and opinions have kind of just died down. I just knew as soon as I was going through all my books and all my one stars and two stars of the year that this is obviously the worst book I read this year. I had more thoughts and opinions over the rest of the list, and that's just how it goes sometimes. So please let me know what your most disappointing book and your obviously your worst book of the year is. What should I not read? And maybe I will read it. So tell me in the comments down below. I'd love to know. And thank you guys for watching, and goodbye.